Babe? I'm watching this Steiner video of yours, and somebody commented that they love your videos, but said, I do have to say I felt a bit cheated on this one. You said some of his finest work was in season two, yet shared not one note of his season two work.
Hey friends, I'm Dave Page and I thank you for stopping by my channel where we look deeply into the music from the original series of Star Trek. This is my season two of scoring Star Trek and I appreciate all of you who jumped in and subscribed and you support the channel. We're going to continue looking into this great music from the original Star Trek. Let's start this season off with more music from the great Dr. Fred Steiner. Well, in the second episode of Season 2, originally aired September 22nd, 1967, Trek fans were treated to another round of spectacular music from the pen of Fred Steiner. Indeed, his complete score for Episode 33, Who Mourns for Adonais, was his personal favorite. The studio session took place the preceding July 12th. As the Enterprise approaches Pollux 4, it is blocked and then snared by an energy field resembling a human hand. Thus the premise of the story. The hand belonged to the ancient Greek god Apollo, who wanted nothing more than just a ship full of humans for company, like it was back in the day, but completely unaware that humanity had changed a lot. But when the green hand appears, Steiner reuses a theme from season one, the Corbomite maneuver, the first of many reused themes out of his impressive repertoire from the year prior. And why not? A great theme is a great theme. In the Corbomite maneuver, recall the Enterprise crew encounters a similar situation with that spinning cube blocking their way and followed by the massive alien ship, Phasarius.
All engines stop. All engines stop. Phaser crew, stand ready.
Reach the phaser crew, stand ready.
Forward phaser will comply. All weapons at operational ready.
Well, for Kirk and the crew in season two, it was deja vu all over again. So why not use the same theme? Steiner opens with the Phasarius theme. But when that hand comes into focus, he transitions to a new motif for everything that's about to threaten the crew.
Analysis, Mr. Spock.
Momentarily.
Am I seeing things?
Not unless I am too. Captain, that thing's a giant hand. What is it, Mr. Spock? Is it, a hand?
Negative, Captain. Not living tissue.
See, this sequence of notes is truly the dilithium crystal that powers much of the music in Adonais. Now, there isn't time to cover every detail in this video, but here are a few variations, including two for lush strings. Listen for the repeated chromatic movements, and in some cases, two at the same time.
External pressure building up, Captain. Becoming clinical, Captain. We can't handle it.
You seem wise for a woman. What is your name?
Lieutenant Balamas.
I mean your name.
Mm-hmm.
crush its empty hull. I have been too patient. I shall be patient no longer.
I must say, Apollo, the way you ape human behavior is remarkable.
Back again in season one, Dr. Steiner composed music for episode 4, Mud's Women. His cue, Three Venuses, powerfully draws us into the strange allure of these mysterious women.
It's all right, darlings. We're in good hands.
Well, this wonderful and versatile motif was revoiced and adapted throughout that episode and tracked many times over in season one. Here, when Apollo feels that Lieutenant Palamas's bow arm should be bare, Dr. Steiner again taps into his previous work. The theme here is rendered the New Venus.
Beautiful.
Yes.
Well, finally, Fred Steiner composed for this episode a brand new motif for Apollo. He noted, it's an old stunt in our lexicon of movie music. If you want to evoke primitive or ancient themes, you always use an open fifth. Page 25 of Jeff Bond's The Music of Star Trek, Profiles in Style, features an image of Dr. Steiner's handwritten original sketch. And working from this, I've made a transcription of QM14, the Apollo motif. Worth mentioning are two wonderful musical moments that I won't develop here. Captain Kirk reminds Lieutenant Palamas of their shared heritage as humans, and that Apollo's plan would doom them to slavery unless she rejects him. The cue, Kirk and Carolyn, beautifully adapts and varies the New Venus theme. And the climatic battle, of course, between Apollo and the Enterprise is nothing short of heart-pounding with Steiner's cue, Apollo's Storm, Final Battle. At its conclusion, he scores the Apollo motif for French horn and violas over the Apollo's power motif with low brass and cellos. It's just brilliant. With his power source reduced to rubble, Apollo must relegate himself to the cosmos with the other gods who long preceded him, admitting they were right, there's no room for gods anymore. I feel that the cue, End of Apollo, is hands down some of Dr. Steiner's best work, a medley of multiple themes, one transitioning to the next. See if you can recognize each one in my transcription score. Thank you. Fortunately, Fred Steiner was just warming up for season two and would go on to provide partial scores for two more episodes. My next video will look at how he reuses the Romulan theme, again from season one, Balance of Terror, for the parallel universe experience in Mirror Mirror, as well as the important variation that gives us the wonderfully dreamy Meet Marlena cue. We'll also take a look at his work by any other name. Well, I want to thank you for stopping by and checking this out. If you enjoy the content, give us a thumbs up. Feel free to subscribe or leave a comment. Until we see you next time, trek long and prosper.